For all film-related interviews, content, and reviews, please subscribe to Pooja Talwar.
Well, I can only start saying many, many congratulations. So all three of you, what was your reaction when you got that nomination, Oscar nomination? Gurneet must be like, haan, ye to hota rehta hai mere saath.
Pooja, thank you. But we are still, I think, 2 weeks away from nomination, 3 weeks away from nomination. We've gotten shortlisted. So the nomination comes around 15th of March. We were very excited when it got shortlisted out of, I think, lots and lots of movies globally. Bittu made it to top 10. And it is our first film that we all came together for. So yes, over the moon, did not sleep the whole night. We were all stress eating, stress texting each other. And it was like hamare board ke exams hai final. And I was so nervous. So yeah, so we were just, you know, all of us, and Ruchika, of course, from Ekta's team, who's a co-conspirer in all of this. We were all just stress texting each other because it came out at 4:30 a.m. India time. It was LA time at 3:30 p.m. So we were all figuring it out ki kab aa raha shortlist. So we were very glad that we made it to the shortlist.
Awesome. Ekta, what was your reaction? And also, I heard you say somewhere that you were so jealous that these two ladies had come up with this concept.
So, you know, actually what happened was I woke up at about 10:30 in the morning after working till 4:30. So just before it got announced, I went to sleep. And I got to know that we had sort of got shortlisted at the Oscars. Now, you know my trajectory. I do really mass content. To be shortlisted at the Oscars. I read Shatairat message 3 times. I want to check if it was Oscars or it was TV awards or what. I mean, then I saw it's Tahira and then it's Bittu and it's really, so it was fantastic. It was a great, and Ruchika was calling me. So I sent 72 missed calls from Ruchika. And then of course, wow. It's Guneet and I was like, I can't believe it. Because I met these two ladies in different spaces at different points of my life. And I was at this, I was searching for an opportunity to actually go out there and do something structured. I've tied up with many female directors and producers, but this was an opportunity when Tahira called me up and I met Guneet and Tahira. And they said, you can do this if you want. I'm like, did you guys just say that? I want. I definitely want to. I mean, and I think I was late to the party, but it was a party. I didn't mind date crashing also. So late is good enough, yeah.
Hardly late. Not at all late. And she's just being very gracious to say all that. I mean to say she's added a lot of power and a lot of strength to Indian Women Rising. And we couldn't have imagined anything without her. So it came to fruition along with Ekta and Ruchika. Matlab, late to the party, kya? Kuch nahi banna tha usse pehle. Usse pehle hum pahunch jate ki hum kare kya? So she's just being gracious enough to say that. But I think, we were very kicked and we are very elated.
I'm sure. Maine to aapko nominate bhi kar diya hai apni taraf se. Hopefully, wo bhi ho jaye. My lips to God's ears. But Tahira, you called yourself a privileged intern with these two magnificent, you know. Maine suna tha. Privileged intern, maine suna. Apne apne ko bola hai.
Yeah. No, but it is, right? It is what it is. I mean to say, so with Guneet, I have worked for the past 1 year and a half, and that was in a professional capacity. And I think, it was a wonderful association. We worked on a short film, we worked on podcast. Between Ekta and me, we really got to know each other when we sat down, we met, and she's heard a couple of stories too. So I think there was a little bit of a connection there already where we were already in sync. These two are diggaj, as you can see. They are queens. They have really, really broken a lot of, things that other people paved way. Put it in a correct way, they paved way for a whole lot of women. And to be in association with such lovely women where I get to not just learn, but also learn that the heart, the intention to share the platform and to share it. So if I am rising, I'm going to make 10 other women rise along with me. And I just feel they just did that with me to begin with. And I am forever indebted that I feel that they both feel that I can contribute and I can bring something to the collective. I feel very, very honored when it comes from both of them, because they both have done whatever they have done on, by themselves. They have reached dizzying heights and really broken a lot of glass ceilings, that they have they have done tremendous work in a setup which is not conducive for women to progress, grow, or give a command, you know. So totally they have done that. So
yeah. All three of you, I would say that. And now, before coming to bit two, why you chose that story, I want to ask all three of you. I know Ekta 25 years ago had basically surprised all the purists, the, you know, the Puritans and the patriarchs, when she put her mom and her name, and to hell with it, and carved her own path. Gunjeet said how she felt, you know, she was young and everybody said, ye bacche se kya hoga? And there you are writing 12 commandments. But what was that one defining moment in your lives as these female creators where you dusted yourself off from maybe the toughest situation and rose to the occasion? That one defining moment.
Gunjeet, you should take that first.
I think, you know, working for my own self for so many years and making independent films and making them travel, putting constantly trying to put Indian stories on the map, there was a point at my life where I just felt, you know, that I am pushing so much and I need to do something about it. There was a moment when I gave myself promotion. I was like, now I'm going to promote myself and I have to stop thinking like this. I have to think like I am running the ship. But that really was a moment of change than being on the other side saying, you know, yeah, I don't have enough. I don't, ye kaise hoga? How will I reach there? Ye kaise hoga? Will somebody believe in me? And it was a switch that happened in my brain that I gave myself promotion because I work for myself. And slowly, I think the world conspired. And I have to say, even outside of this, Ekta deeply has empowered me. And so has Tahira. And I actually really enjoy this this unity and the team, because I've been like running solo for very long and I have missed this chance of doubling down on each other, you know. So I, with Tahira, I feel like 1+1=3. With Tahira, Rujika, Ekta, I'm just like on top of the world. I'm like, and when I spoke to Karishma, I said, you have to imagine us as being your, you know, any of your wish, like what do you want for Bittu? You know, how should we campaign? And we are on it, you know. So I think that kind of, I know it's a bit of a longer answer, but my change happened for myself. And right now I feel deeply, deeply empowered. Like I'm running the world. I feel like that with this power behind me. So yeah.
Tahira and Ekta.
Tahira, you take this first again.
Ekta's preparing the best answer. You go. I will get 100 out of 100.
No. Okay, I'll go. Okay? So my whole thing is, I think I've felt that a million times, because you're not in a career if you don't feel at one point threatened, scared, vulnerable. It's a part of our jobs. Male, female, anyone feels it. But what really happens with women at work, and for me, 27 years now, it's happened millions of times, is that people tend to put you in boxes. And it's a really big problem. Like, you make soap, so they think that, are isko ye regressive shows yaate. First of all, I don't know what, if you're wearing a sari, how it's regressive, but anyway, that's a different conversation. Then they want to, if you make, go and make an alt, they're like, okay, you can only do this. When I started my app, they said you can't compete with the big boys in the game. I just feel it's so, people want to limit you, you know, and it is somewhere you can actually, I agree with Gunjeet, you know, in a lone game, you can fall for that trap, that belief that people throw on you, that this is all you can do. And actually, all that you can do is everything.
Yeah.
So, and you know, you sometimes need that. Like I never would have been, and I'm saying this honestly, part of even presenting a film that would be shortlisted for an Oscar. I thought it never passed my dream also. I limited myself. I thought I only make a certain kind of content and I can only present a certain kind of content. And then here come these two fantastic women and we start collective and my mind has opened up. And so have my opportunities. And I have these women, and we have so many more women to help break that format that people have put them and their lives and their mindsets in.
Absolutely. Or, I mean, yeah. Totally agree with that.
Completely. Yeah. Dono ko de do, aap 100 marks. Mera isi mein cover ho gaya.
Aap bhi ho, commandments aapne jo likhe hain.
No, of course, no, this is not to undermine anything, but I just believe, I really, really believe whatever these two have said. I think challenges, the more challenges you face, that you always have a choice. What do you do about that challenge? Either you succumb or you use it as a springboard and you go on to the next level. And that's not to say that you will not face another challenge. On the next level too, there's going to be another challenge, perhaps even tougher than the previous one, because you have had the experience of dealing with the first stage, you also have those powers to deal with the second stage. So it's expanding your life every time a challenge is thrown at you. Now, something that limits us is our belief, the world, the society, like Ekta says, it puts you in a box. So each and every time to reaffirm yourself on a daily basis that nobody can stop me from dreaming. And who is there to tell me that these dreams will come true and these dreams are beyond your capability? Who is anyone to judge my abilities and capability? Who is anybody to judge my power? So the switch which you're talking about is a daily determination for most of us to know that today I'm going to have an undefeated spirit. I'm not going to let the world, their thinking, their stupid way of putting us in the boxes, I'm not going to let that get the better of me. And that requires a whole lot of push, whole lot of camaraderie, and something that we find in Indian Women Rising. So, yeah.
I can see that in the three of you and those two girls in Bittu. Now, let's talk about the film. Bittu and Chand, spunky little things. And of course, anyone who's seen it, the end really breaks your heart. What was it that worked for the three of you when this movie came and you were like, this is going to be our first?
Love at first sight.
Everything. Yeah. It was just, we guys just loved it. And I think Bittu is, because of Bittu, Indian Women Rising is there because it's the first project that we are helming. So right from the filmmaker's intention to how the cinematography was done, there was so much of heart and yet the finesse, the craft was there as well. And that really sort of, and the storyline, I think everything was just bang on. It breaks your heart at the same time. It doesn't let you, the cinematography doesn't take you away from it. It's not overwhelming. It just adds layers and mood to the entire story. So yeah, I think that's what worked for me, and I'm sure for the other lovely women too. Yeah.
And you know, it's Karishma and Shreya. They're both sisters. One is a director, one is a DOP. And it's Karishma Dev Dubey and Shreya Dev Dubey. And it's beautiful. It's just gorgeous. It's and Bittu and Chand just have my heart. They
absolutely.
And I think, you know, while we're all doing such large fiction, long format work, here is a shot that comes our way and, you know, just totally inspires us to come together, to do something else, you know, like Ekta said, to open our vision that we can also do all this, you know, and we just got started and now opportunities are coming our way. Yeah. So we are actually very grateful to Karishma and Shreya to put together Bittu and, of course, to reach out to us. And now we are doing what we can from, you know, protecting it and taking it to the next level with all our power.
Absolutely. Also, Ekta, it's amazing because when you started, you were this young girl, like, you know, all
still am a young girl.
You're still a young girl. And also what I like about this, it's very empowering because there are a lot of women there. But, you know, the thing is, this is 2-3 of you. I start with Ekta because, you know, first young producer, 27 saal pehle, you know, patriarchy, a glass ceiling, yeah, we can, the glass was shattered and we could still, you know, see the pieces around. You know, actresses start so young, but what is that one reason that we don't see the same happening for women behind, you know, like the camera and all that? What do you think needs to change for that environment to now build up and become regular?
Structure. I think structure is a very big word because, unfortunately, we don't think of this profession as anything but a hobby for a lot of women. You know, I mean, we still have to get better educational institutions for media, you know. I think that's a huge problem. And I think for people like me, we stumbled upon it. I mean, I started 18 because I just landed up saying, I'm going to make this. My dad said he's going to start a company. He didn't. I had no job. And he was like, if you don't get into work, then what will you do? Would you want to get married? That word marriage only scared me. I said, I'll do anything. I'll start my own company. Like, this is not going to happen with me. And I did this and it happened. But, you know, I mean, I was pushed against the wall. Clearly, I didn't look like any of the young girls who could be launched at that time. And clearly, no one was running after me to make a film with me with a top star out there. And that lack of opportunity turned out to be the biggest opportunity for my life, you know. And somewhere, I mean, I didn't follow the path that most star kids do. And I did my own thing. And it worked for me. So I think we have to, again, break the mindset. If a lawyer or a doctor has a young girl and she's so made to study till she's 24 and then she realizes that she wants to get into media, then she thinks, I've spent so many years here, how will I make the switch and stuff like that. So there should be more acceptance of young women in media. I hope all of us who started young have set some example for girls to say, okay, it can happen to me too.
Totally.
True.
Yeah, and Tahir and Guneet, too. Guneet also, poor thing, faced the same thing because itni choti si. Like we discussed, it's ageist also that, you know, you have to have lots of experience. Young banda kya kar sakta hai. So what would you want to say to build up a cohesive environment and encouraging, empowering environment for many young girls who are looking at you?
I think firstly, we are not competition. We are a team. You know, we are each other's team. And there is enough and more work for all of us and many of us to come in and grow and shine. So we have to get out of that mindset ki agar usko mil gaya to tujhe nahi milega, you know, usko bhi milega aur hame aur bhi acha milega, you know. And the more we empower the other, the more we get empowered in our own way, in our own shape and size. So I think the journey on Bittu also, I relate to it because I feel like this is a relay, you know. The girls, Shreya, Mary, Karishma, they made a beautiful film. They came to me, I ran to Tahira, Tahira ran to Ekta. It's a relay. And, you know, and
absolutely,
all of us are empowering each other. And this is the
beautifully
circle.
Put.
You know, this is a circle that we are in and we are doubling down on each other, you know, ki kya chahiye? And then it's done. And we are using all our resources and might to do this. And that is what is magical. And when that happens, no, the trajectory is not 1x, it's 10x, it's 100x. Totally. You know, and that's what will further, that needs to be told to everybody, that we are all one team, more absolutely. Of us. So each one of us goes forward, will make room for 10 more. And that's absolutely. The spirit. So I think that's what I've seen. A team can do one.
Yeah, Tahira, what would you want to say? Like you wanted to, you know, you've been writing a lot.
Yeah, and I think we discussed it also with the 12 commandments of being a woman. And if there's anything that I want to share with women is that never underestimate yourself. I did for a very, very long time, and God knows why I did, and I just kept getting inside my shell. But and it's also never too late to start all over again. Or like, you know, how Ekta was saying that, you know, at 24 you've started sciences, and that's what I did. I am a BSc biotechnology graduate. I'm a science graduate, and then I went into mass medium and journalism, and then after that I did 20 other jobs, did extremely well in them, but I was so lost for the longest time. But do I hold that against me right now? Does it limit me because I'm now a mom, I have two kids, and it's too late to start? No. I mean to say, I'm not going to let these things limit me. But there's no one who's going to tell you that. The world is kind, but it's not kind enough to make time for you to sit you down and counsel you. You need to do that for yourself. You need to be absolutely. A biggest cheerleader. You need to really, really love yourself. To choose to love myself, it has been the biggest learning for me. I have, like, there are a lot of people who are in love with themselves already, which is amazing. But people like me, we really have to try hard to really be appreciative about themselves and to be okay and say, okay, yeah. Fine, you've done this. It's okay to do whatever you feel like at whatever stage in life you are at. So that's what I want to share with women and with girls, that they should dream, and they should dream really, really big. And make absolutely. All their dreams happen. Yeah. So.
True. And before we go, last question. This is, what is the kind of content we are going to see? Where does it go from here? What are you looking at? Ekta said she wanted to bridge that gap between sari and swimsuit. Wo ho chuka hai waise. So lastly, to the three of you, what is the kind of content we are looking at now?
I think
sari, swimsuit, trunks, without any clothes.
Yeah, I think... individually, we are all doing a large series of content, movies and shows. And I think individually, we are all doing that in our companies, in our personal spaces, working with each other also. But this Indian Women Rising, we've come together to amplify, to discover, to amplify, to market, sell, just beautiful content made by women that we can add our value to. So it could be a documentary, it could be a, another short film, it could be a feature, it could be a show, it could be, I mean, we don't know what's ahead for us, but where we think we can add value in this extremely underserviced area of marketing, distribution, reaching out. And like I said, you know, Bittu won the Oscar, student Oscar in October. And here we are talking about it now. Like India has discovered Karishma Dev Dubey and Bittu. And, you know, India is cheering and our country is cheering.
Totally rising.
And that is our work. That is precisely the energy and our work of Indian Women Rising. You know, this journey that we've lived with Bittu, and we are, this is like literally our phase one, and we are figuring out what we will do. We have a website, we are being pitched projects, but we really have to fall in love with something. It's a lot of time, energy, resources. So it is about falling in love with something.
Absolutely. Last parting words, Ekta.
So I actually agree with Guneet. I think it doesn't matter if the story has someone in a swimsuit or a sari. It's a story that matters. The lens shifts when it comes to Indian Women Rising. As I said, it's not a Balaji telefilm or a Balaji motion pictures where clearly the intent is to make content that has to have a bottom line and top line. This is to empower more women. And I have joined hands with these two great, amazing women for that intent.
Absolutely. More power to the three of you and many congratulations. Hope we can do a virtual cheers very soon.
Yes.
Thank you so much. Thank you. All the very best. Bye. All the very best. Congratulations. Bye.
If you've liked this interview, please like, share and subscribe. Follow me on Twitter and Instagram.